All hail Bohm and I. Yes, God.
Welcome to the Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 6 reunion, where all the queens return to answer questions from the judges. We crown Miss Congeniality and fan favorite, and Tumblr's next drag superstar. So stay tuned.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 6 reunion. Are you ladies ready? Please welcome back Miss Trixie LaCroche.
Oh yeah. Don't hate me cause I'm beautiful. And where is the body? Move over, mother. Cause I'm going faster.
Faster
than you.
Than you.
Can drive.
Can drive.
The body's beautiful, baby.
Hey TDR judges, it's everyone's favorite crotch, Trixie LaCroche.
Trixie LaCroche, why do you think you weren't brought back into the competition? Do you feel like you have more to offer the TDR community?
Okay, let's be honest. The fans bringing someone back, that's really, I think it's favoritism. If you really want to bring someone back, they need to do a play along. Because I think they need to prove that they have what it takes to be, to still remain in this competition. Like, nothing wrong against Katrina, I love her. But, you know, I had no problem with it. I'm over it. But I really wanted to come back, so I'm just upset that I didn't get to come back.
Trixie LaCroche, my absolute favorite crotch. I took some time to not do my homework in order to be here to ask you one very important question. Being the Ixie from the world-famous pop girl group, Rojixie, how does it feel to not be in the finale next to your two bestest friends in the whole world? Ava Amiibo and Robin Ratbush.
It's a relief, it's a blessing. Like, I really didn't have the money to continue in this competition. But you know what? I'm fine with it. They're my best friends. I'm so happy for them. I'm just wish them all the best of luck in the world. Excuse me?
Please welcome back Miss Flora Mandragora.
Good evening. This is Flora Mandragora. Welcome to my boudoir. It's not my boudoir. It's my sister's boudoir. She's in Iceland. I'm stealing her room. My room's full of shit. It's awful. It's really messy. Let's get on with the questions. How about that?
Flora Mandragora, after taking the Charm School crown, did you expect some of the Cycle 6 queens to be intimidated by you winning your way into the competition?
No. I never for a moment expected anyone to be intimidated by me. If anything, I thought I'd be under a magnifying glass because they're like, alright, you're apparently good enough to beat all these other girls. Let's see what you got. So, no, I didn't think anyone would really be intimidated by me. But I hope I did some looks that were interesting and that people thought, even if they weren't executed the best, like my rock chick look, I hope it came across that I was trying to put a fresh spin on things. The only thing I do think is after my avant-garde look, I hope I surprised a few people with that. Because that was really fun, and a lot of people on the tag were saying things like, oh, I never expected Flora to do this. That's actually very me, I just never got around to doing a look like that. So, I hope that turned a few heads. Good way or bad way, that's what avant-garde's all about.
You were one of my Charm School girls, and I was really proud of what you've done so far. With that being said, you had such interesting concepts in TDR. Are we going to see any more Flora Mandragora anytime soon?
Liz, your question is probably the cutest thing I've ever read, so thank you so much. I had a brilliant, brilliant time on Charm School, and I'm really grateful to you and all the other judges and all the Charm School girls for it. Will you be seeing more of Flora? Short answer, because we've only got 2 minutes. Yes, absolutely. I'm going to be going to Pride later, and I've got a whole outfit arranged for that. It's the same day as Taylor Swift, so that's going to be an interesting concert afterwards. And I want to go on to doing more and interesting things and hopefully posting about it on the tag. So with any luck, you'll be seeing more of me in the future. And yeah.
Please welcome back Miss Sabrina Citrus.
Hi Sabrina, and welcome to the reunion. What I wrote for you is really long, so I hope that you don't mind if I read it off my screen because I can't remember all this. I'm sorry, I love you. Okay, Sabrina Citrus, when I first saw your audition tape, do you know what my first thought was? This bitch is me. The rent, the Pokemon, the smiling, you were always so happy and energetic throughout the cycle, and even when things didn't work out in your favor, and to be honest, your positivity was a breath of fresh air that I needed and every other contestant needed to see. Now, I have a two-part question for you. Number one, what made you start doing drag? And number two, where do you see your drag career 5 years from today?
Hi, that's actually really sweet of you to say, thank you. Yeah, like, I noticed that too, like, I was a huge fan of Gade before I auditioned for TDR, so I was really excited to find out that she was doing Cycle 6. And it's funny because Bent was actually part of the reason why I became a drag queen. When I watched it when I was 14 years old, I decided I wanted to be a drag queen, but it wasn't until I was 17, last October, that I decided that I would actually do it, and I actually ordered this book, and it was going ahead. In 5 years' time, I see myself, well, I'm moving to Newcastle in September, so I'm hoping to get more nightclub bookings there. I mean, I have a regular gig starting here in June, but, like, I don't know, it's not very big around here, so I want to move somewhere where it's bigger. And then once I finish my course in Newcastle, I'll be 21. And I want to go down south and maybe Brighton, because I really like Brighton and I think it's a great place. And a lot of the drag seem to be down south, so hopefully I'll be moving there to do this stuff. Yay! Also, in 5 years' time, I will be finally turning 12 years old, which means that I will be closer to being eligible for RuPaul's Drag Race UK, if that ever happens, which I hope it does.
Sabrina Citrus, my fellow theater queen, you've shown us that you're quite the thespian throughout this competition. Do you care to sing us a little show tune?
Look at my look, ain't I looking good? Look out Manhattan and Hollywood. Look at my glass, doing what I should. Look at me, can't you see I'm fabulous, baby? Check me out, ain't no doubt where this girl should go. So let all you want, I won't be denied. What I have got is too hard to hide. I am fabulous, baby. Fresh, free, fabulous, baby, fine, and fabulous, wait and see.
Please welcome back Miss Vivian Lynch.
Thanks for having me. Such an honor.
Vivian Lynch, we loved you on this cycle of TDR. Besides fighting off crocs and scorpions, what's next for Vivian Lynch?
Well, I'm moving back to Adelaide to study makeup full time because it's got the best course and cheapest fees, all that. So hopefully Vivi's makeup will get better. Ideally, Vivi will perform for the first time in the next few months. Every Sunday at a bar in Adelaide there is an afternoon for drag, and there's often new queens there.
Hi Vivi, we wish you could have hung around for another week. As you found out, your sense of humor wasn't always very well received by the general public in the competition. Seeing the week that you left was a comedy challenge, how do you think you would have fared against your sisters? And what do you believe would have happened that week?
Well, I think we experienced this with Courtney Act in season 6 of Drag Race. And I unfortunately did say that I wouldn't be like her in my audition, but there we go. It seems Australians have a colder, almost harsher tone. We're more blunt. I don't know what it is, but my humour really wasn't received too well in the competition. In terms of that challenge, the children's one, I don't think I would have really produced anything of extraordinary quality. Really disappointed that I just did not have the time to do it that week, which is why I had to tell the judges that I couldn't do it, and thus I was disqualified. I didn't quit. So yes, I've taken away a lot from the competition. My makeup's gotten better. I now have a drag wardrobe. I had my audition dress at the beginning of the competition, so that's amazing. To the new winner of Tumblr's Drag Race, Tumblr's next drag superstar, just be careful when thinking about future challenges and put some thought into why we're doing them, why the competitors are doing them. But other than that, thank you. See you later. Bye.
Please welcome back Miss Katrina Prowess.
I'm Katrina Prowess, and welcome to the reunion.
That was stupid.
Hi, I'm Katrina Prowess, and we're gonna answer some motherfucking questions.
That was stupid too.
Katrina Prowess, out of all of the audition videos, yours blew up the most. What do you think made you stand out and get to 59 no's?
I don't know. I didn't really think it blew up that much. I guess it just blew up the most out of the girls in the competition. I don't know. I guess maybe because I think I looked really good in my audition video. So maybe that had something to do with it. I have a personality, so maybe that's it too. Yeah, I don't know.
Katrina, in our Unclock chat, you've been one of the girls who hasn't been afraid to share her opinions. Don't get me wrong, I'm the same way. I don't shut the fuck up. But my question to you is this. Do you have any opinions you want to share about the cycle? Any decisions you don't agree with? Any eliminations apart from your own, obviously? Or just tell us your general thoughts on Cycle 6 and how it's played out.
Well, it's definitely been a circus. Well, let's get into this. Of course, I'm very thankful I got brought back into the competition, and my second elimination I did not have a problem with, because I went home to my sister, Slayer Gemini, and I wouldn't have wanted to go home to anybody but her. Speaking of, her elimination was ridiculous. It was unnecessary and stupid. Instead of doing that last challenge that she got eliminated on, we should have just gone on to the final challenge, because that, it doesn't make any sense to me to make it a top two instead of a top three. That's bananas to me, and it shouldn't have happened. She shouldn't have been eliminated, blah, blah, blah. My opinions don't matter. I got eliminated. So yeah, all I have to say is Slayer shouldn't have gone home. Katrina shouldn't have gone home. And people with busted mugs shouldn't throw stones.
Please welcome back Miss Effie Von Slayer.
Oh, well, hello there, and welcome back to my life.
Effie Von Slayer, you were the only queen from your clique, Katrina Van Lush, to make it to the final three. How does that feel?
Well, I mean, I know you all want to hear about Katrina Van Lush because of the feud between me and Sunday. Okay, so here it is. Katrina and Sunday were probably the first people to talk to me in this whole competition once we all found out who everyone was. During the first challenge. To be fair, I didn't really know anyone, so I kind of just went with whoever would talk to me. Katrina and I are still very good friends. Sunday and I clearly are not. It is what it is. Life goes on. I'm not mad. I mean, I may poke a little fun from time to time, but who doesn't? And just with that being said, Sunday, I am sorry if you are watching this. I'm gonna refrain from making any comments any further. Okay, so, to be the only one to make it from the three of us, math is hard. I mean, I'm proud that I made it this far. Katrina made it almost as far as I did. You know, the click didn't hurt us. I don't feel that it also helped us in any way, shape, or form. It was just nice to have someone to talk to throughout the competition.
You've recently announced that you've been adopted into the House of Gemini, which is a huge opportunity for you. Congratulations. But if you wouldn't mind, tell us a little bit about that, how it happened, what it means, and how Slayer Gemini really came to be.
Well, I know everyone in the TDR tag knows me as Effie, and I mean, I'll still respond to Effie, but I did join the House of Gemini. It is a local house here in Orlando. The House of Gemini is very selective. They pick people, you don't pick them. Joining a house, I was advised against it, actually, by multiple people. However, the House of Gemini is very club kid oriented, and as a drag queen, I relate more to that because I do more conceptual looks and I want to make people guess. I don't want to be a princess every fucking day of my life. So, I feel that the variety of this family will help me, it'll help me grow, it'll help me develop myself better.
Please welcome back Miss A Vagina.
Hey everybody, it's everyone's favorite orifice, A Vagina here. After 87 weeks of competition, we're finally at the reunion, and I can't wait to dive right into these questions. So let's get started.
A Vagina, it's no secret that you auditioned for Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 4. If you had made it onto that cycle, do you think you would have made it to the final three, just like this one?
I did make it very clear that I had auditioned for Cycle 4 and I was rejected in favor of Bobo Bet. But let's face it, I look like this. Wasn't she adorable? Someone should probably call the police. That crease has murdered those eyebrows. To answer your question, if I had made it on there, I would not have made it to top 3, or probably top 6, or probably top 8. I was so new to it, and I was so unprepared. I was still unprepared for what was happening this cycle, but I think if I had made it on there, I would have either been the queen who lip-synced 3 times and left, or I would have probably gone out the window with Boxa. I'm not sure, but come on, cycle 6, let's get me further than I would have gotten on the cycle I auditioned for. Woo!
A Vagina. Hi. I know that you're upset because we removed the high fashion celebrity impersonation cosplay challenge where you wear all 6 colors while filming a horror film in addition to a romantic comedy strip, all set to the tone of human behavior, as it would have been your 3rd gold star. Do you feel that you should have won more than 2 gold stars this cycle? But wait, there's more, just like every challenge this cycle. In addition to spilling the tea this week, A Vagina is required to show off her Monopoly collection because I said so.
If you couldn't tell, I'm a hoarder, and so I have a lot of these. I think it's like 127. And it goes all the way from like original Monopoly to Oh Hello Kitty Monopoly, the Smurfs, Ghettoopoly, that one's inflatable Monopoly, Disney Monopoly. So I just have a lot. Yay, Monopoly. Back to questions. No, but seriously, I'm extremely happy with my performance on this cycle. The only week where I deserved the star was week 7, the old lady from Atlantic City, and there's not a goddamn person on planet Earth that can tell me that I did not win that goddamn challenge. But because I had some teammates that don't know how to take stage direction very well, that cost me the star. But I am so happy with my performance as that character. I think it's one of my best performances I've done on this cycle, and that's worth more to me than a star. The only other star that I think I deserved when I was doing it was the week 12 Harlequin look. I thought, oh my god, this is the first time I've completed a complete outfit. I loved it, and then I was in the bottom. But you know what? It was top 3. I made it that far without being in the bottom, so I don't know what that means, but yeah.
Please welcome back Miss Robin Cradle.
Hi, it's Robin Cradles. You probably remember me as Problematic Fave from Cycle 6 or Trash from Cycle 5.
Miss Cradles, I'd personally like to extend you an enormous congratulations for making it to the final two. I know, speaking to you personally, that you were excited to even make it to the top 10. And every week after that was just more motivation for you. So that being said, you're here now at the end and you're already looking onward to Cycle 7, as we know. My question is, what do you want for the future of TDR? What are your goals for the community? And also, do you still look to Bobo Bett for guidance?
For starters, of course I still worship Bobo Bett. And anyone who doesn't worship Bobo Bett is living a lie. You're living a lie. You're not living a fulfilled life. And that's all that matters. What do I want for the future of TDR? I want an actual community, not a broken community. And I want to be a voice. So if those older psycho girls have an issue with how something is being run, I want to be a voice that they can come to and be like, look, here's my idea. Here's my idea to approach this. And that's what I want for the future of TDR. I want it to be a collaborative effort on the part of the community. And I actually want a TDR community again.
Hi, Robin. Although you returned and found a place in the hearts of many fans, you heard some not-so-positive things from people on Tumblr, including some past contestants, including this one just really aggressive and obnoxious queen who just can't go away and keep her rude-ass opinions to herself. On this first episode of Reading with Garnet, how do you respond to this backlash? You've done a lot of interviews before this cycle, so now it's your turn. Go get 'em.
I don't think I gathered as much backlash as I expected to, because doing Cycle 5, I was getting literal death threats. Literal, like, kill yourself, literal jump in front of a car, literally telling me to die. And so when I came back, I expected the same sort of thing, same sort of treatment, same everything. I expected people to hate it, they didn't want me there, and I mean, I experienced some of it. Like, some of the other Cycle 6 girls were all like, oh, you're gonna go home, you're not gonna make it, blah, 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 blah. I don't know what it is, but I just make people mad. I have my entire life. But as far as it being backlash and how it affects me, yes, it affects me to a certain point. Opinions of other people will always affect everyone. I don't care what you say. I walk around like, I don't give a fuck, I'm so confident, but those comments still affect me. Things you read can still affect you. I don't care what you say. You're not telling me anything I didn't already have told to me before. Girl, I don't know what else to say. I mean, I'm not gonna retaliate. That isn't my game. I'm not gonna sit here and be like, oh my God, Rita said this about me and she's trash. Or Wednesday said this about me and she's trash. Because they're not. They're not trash. They're not. But I don't believe that I should go and downgrade other people because they are downgrading me. That's not my bag. That's not my game. And that's all I'm gonna, like, I don't consider it even backlash, because bitch is gonna talk. And Wednesday always squawking. So, I mean, let us squawk. It's nothing more than words. I mean, right on the top of her Tumblr, it says, I'm Cody, I'm mean. What do you expect? Like, it affected me for probably, like, 3 minutes until everyone told me to just shut up and shove it. Like,
also, as last cycle's Miss Congeniality and the first Miss Congeniality in the history of TDR, is my job to pass on the theoretical sash of Miss Congeniality. And after speaking to all the girls this cycle and gathering votes, I am happy to announce that Miss Congeniality of this cycle is Sabrina Cetris!
Yay!
Say yay!
Yay!
In addition to the final coronation of the winner of Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 6, we have one final star to give away, and this is for fan favorite. So without further ado, it's time to announce who is getting the next rainbow star on the banner. With a whopping total of 14 votes, the winner of Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 6's fan favorite vote is Miss Vivian Lynch! Congratulations, Vivian. You are the sixth recipient of the Fan Favorite Award on Tumblr's Drag Race. Everybody loves you, and with very good reasoning, because look how beautiful you are. Seriously. Damn.
And now to crown our winner. A Vagina. Your lip-syncing skills are unmatched. Your looks are dynamite. You're a talented makeup artist, and you have a personality that's out of this world. And you're a very polished comedian. Your body of work is amazing, and out of every TDR queen in history, you have the most stars on your banner. Robin Cradles, from being the first queen eliminated from Cycle 5 to being in the top 2 of Cycle 6, you've come such a long way, proving that it doesn't matter what kind of queen you are or what skills you have. If you are determined, you can do anything. You are very invested in this competition, and you've improved a lot. You have a huge heart, and you're a very genuine person, as well as a talented queen. But only one of you can take the crown. The winner of TDR Cycle 6, Tumblr's Next Drag Superstar, is... A Vagina! Congratulations, my dear. Do you have anything to say?
Me, A Vagina, the small girl from New Orleans, won Tumblr's Drag Race Cycle 6. I'm ecstatic. I'm truly, oh my god. It's literally a dream come true. I remember auditioning for Cycle 4 and thinking, you know, oh, you're gonna make it to the top, you're gonna win. You're gonna win, you're gonna slay all these hosts. And I didn't even make it on the damn cycle. But it feels like it was all worth it. All of the hardships, all of the tears, all of the threatening to quit all the time, all of the fears that I was gonna go home, it's all worth it. I made it and I did it. I set out on this dream almost 2 years ago. And to find an outlet like this, to really explore my craft, it's been a blessing. And to get a crown, to get the crown, is the icing on the cake. I mean, with all the experiences from this competition, I've grown so much, but just to be able to say I got it and I won and I got that crown, it truly is that next level. And there's so many people I have to thank. First, I'm gonna thank the judges for all of their hard work, their critiques, every week trying to get me to improve and to branch out. I'm so appreciative for all of that. And also for your open ears whenever I needed to talk or ask questions or get your opinion on things. Thank you for always being there and really helping me reach this level. Next, I'm gonna thank one of my best friends in the whole world, Trixie LaCroche. We came on this journey together. You went home really early. I'm really happy about that because I didn't have to take you down myself. But you know I love you. You've grown so much and I'm so glad we got to share this experience together. Robin Cradles, my competitor, the one I had to take down to get this crown. We have become the best friends. And I thought going into this competition, yeah, I'm gonna meet people, I'm gonna talk to people, but I never thought that I would connect with someone who lives so far away from me over the internet. And we started texting pretty early, like week 2, or even before week 1 was posted. And I honestly feel like I've known you for so much longer than I have. You and Trixie have been my closest friends in this competition, and your support and your love has really made the difference throughout these entire past 13, 14, whatever weeks. I love you. You've grown so much. I'm so proud of you. And I'm so glad that I got to share this platform with you and to make it all the way. We set out with Team Rojixie, and even though Trixie's not here, but she is, she was always there, always, we made it. We set out that goal and we did it, and I love you so, 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 so much. And of course, I'm gonna get hit watching this video if I don't say it, and I truly mean it. My fiance, Jonathan, I have never met a person who can put up with all my bullshit like you can. I wouldn't have been able to do this. You encouraged me to do Cycle 4. You were there when I didn't make Cycle 4. You told me, do it again. And we waited till Cycle 6, and you've been the most supportive person in my life. And just from helping me through the tough times to helping me pick out outfits to helping me sew, put nails on. You've been there every step of the way, and I couldn't have asked for a better person in my life. You truly care about me, and you love me inside and out. You love Andrew, you love Ava, you love everything, and I don't know, I'm getting dramatic. I sometimes feel like I don't really acknowledge everything you do for me, and I just want you to know that I love you so much, and these past almost 3 years that we've been together have been the best 3 years of my life. I've never had someone who has truly believed in me every single step of the way and would do anything to help me get to the next level. I can't wait for us to start our lives together. I can't wait to see what the future holds with us, and I can't wait to be your husband, because I couldn't imagine being with anyone else, and I love you, babe. Thank you. Anyway, before I start crying, thank you to all the fans, everyone who sent me messages on Tumblr, on Facebook, saying, I'm Team Ava, I want you to win, that dress was sickening. I've appreciated and truly valued every single one of those messages. And to all the fan art, from Zoom to the letter G to Vanilla Frosting, all of you guys, it tickles me pink. That's the one thing that I came into this competition, I said, I want fan art. And you guys delivered. So thank you so much. And to everyone who's watched and paid attention in the tag and ignored all the crazy stuff that happened, thank you for sticking through it. There are so many things that are gonna happen in this next cycle, and I'm so excited to get started. I'm so excited to bring about some of these changes that this community needs to become a true community. And I want you guys, everyone from past contestants to contestants who want to be on in future cycles, viewers, anybody, please, if you have an idea of what can help TDR grow and rise up from where it is and where it has fallen short, please let me know, because I want it to be involved and I want it to become a true community where we have people from different sides giving their ideas to help this become a great thing that it needs and can be. And I think that's it. I'm so excited to be Tumblr's next drag superstar. I hope to wear the crown with honor, and I hope to bring honor to Tumblr. And that's it. I love you guys. I hope you've stayed wet this entire competition. And yeah, see you next time.
Goodbye, everybody. And I'll probably never see you again on Tumblr's Drag Race. So good luck with everything you do. And all of you contestants are beautiful. And you have so much potential. And, you know, I'll be on Facebook if you ever need help and just want to talk, whatever. But, you know, it's been really nice getting to know all of you despite all of the, like, kind of nasty parts of this cycle, let's be real. But yeah, you're all beautiful and you're all talented, and I can't wait to see where you all are a year from today. So it's been nice knowing each of you, and although I won't be here on Tumblr for cycle 7, I'll still be watching with everyone else.
There's a lot that comes with judging, but it is a very rewarding experience. I met 16 or 17 very, very talented girls, and sure, we're not all always a cohesive bunch, and we all don't speak every single day, but I am very glad to have known the people I've known because of judging, and I'm very thankful for this opportunity. So I guess that's all.
I think this has been a great cycle. I think we've had some amazing queens. I want to thank Donna Vanity, Fever LaRue, Gemini DeBarbe, and Garde Valentine for being my judging panel this cycle. I've loved working with you ladies. And I want to give a special thank you to Queen Liz for helping us out a lot this cycle and even appearing in this reunion. It's been a lot of fun, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds for Tumblr's Drag Race. And congratulations to our winner, A Vagina. I wish you all the best of luck, and ta-ta!